What's up, you guys? I mentioned earlier I'm probably not gonna make another video for a couple months, but I guess that came a little bit sooner. I said I was working on a couple of projects right now, and I just recently finished one of them. Now, if you watched my recent stop action video or the preview of it, like my setup for stop action videos, you'll see I had the Predator figure that I customized myself. So this is a variation of that. I've been recently back. I used back in the day. I was really into Devil May Cry. I played the demo for the first one, and I was hooked immediately. And recently, I've been getting back into it because I not too long ago watched the Devil May Cry anime series. You guys may know that my intro used to feature it. And recently I've been looking for a Dante figure, and I noticed all of them are either expensive or they're out of the country, and I just don't deal with shipping out of the country. So I figured I'd actually try and make my own, and I think it came out really good. Now, what I used, I had a G.I. Joe figure. It was a Cobra, I guess it was a foot soldier type figure or something, and I also had an old Luke Skywalker figure for my old Star Wars figures. I found these because I was looking through them to see which ones I really wanted to keep, which ones I was going to throw away. And I kind of wanted to keep these, but I was just like, I don't see what I'm going to be able to do with them. So, alright, let's take a closer look at it. Okay, so I made the cloak, actually. I had an old binder I used for school, and it had like a red material on it. I was going to use a shirt, but I didn't have any old red shirts. And this actually worked really good. It was really, really easy to actually cut off the binder. Really easy to work with. Super glue actually glued with it really easily, too. As you can see, I was able to make a little sheath type thing to hold the sword. That's another thing I made too. I made the sword completely by itself as well. Now, I really couldn't have done a better job. Well, maybe in the positioning, but like as far as looks go, I couldn't get it too close to his actual sword. But I didn't have anything that had the right blade shape, and couldn't really get the ribs to work out too well either. But, you know, I could have probably positioned the pieces a little bit more accurately. And my dad has all these different paints he uses when he goes fishing. He paints his own lures and things like that. So that's what I used for the hair, to make it white because it was blonde. And I just used super glue to make sure the paint doesn't chip off, which actually seems to be working really well. Now for the black sleeves right here, I actually was able to use duct tape. And it were, well, not duct tape, but the black, you guys know what I mean. Actually have it right here. It's like this, and it actually worked really well. I thought it was gonna look crappy as hell, but it actually really worked out pretty good. Now he can't really hold the sword on his right hand, but he can hold it pretty good on his left, which I find kind of weird. In most action figures it's like that. And This is like my first just total rework of an action figure, like completely, where parts are being just ripped off and everything. And I think for my first, I did a pretty good job. I've seen some other custom-made ones on the internet. Some of them are good, some of them are pretty crappy. I think this one's somewhere in between those. I see. I could have made some improvements to certain places, but overall, I'm pretty happy with the job I made, and it's still really posable. I could have probably one thing I probably could have done was made the head twistable, but I just didn't want to worry about that. But yeah, overall. I hope you guys thought it was pretty cool. All right, that about wraps up this video. Thank you guys for watching.